Hey, Kev, what are you doing?
Well, today's a class. Tim over at AskTheBuilder.com, great site, go check it out, emailed and he said, how come when I'm using my welder, he never sees me change the rod? Well, this is a rod from an arc welder, or a stick welder, they used to call it. And when you get started with one of these, it's in your gun over here in your hand. And when you have to scratch it across your work or tap it on your work to get the arc to start. And then as the rod sits there and burns away and gets shorter and shorter, you have to keep moving your rod in to keep that distance apart from your metal so you can keep the arc going. These are great for outdoors, out in the wind. I actually use a variation of these underwater, which is really bizarre. But there's a lot of smoke. There's a lot of splatter, a lot of cleanup to do. And then the flux that's on the outside of this rod that actually melts to protect the filler on the inside makes a coating over the weld that you have to go back and chip off, because otherwise it'll just fall off and then you have a gap in your paint. So there's a lot of cleanup that happens with this. Now this is my MIG welder that, Tim, you saw me using. And this is the kind of gun that it has. With an arc welder, the rod would attach to the gun here. With a MIG welder, the wire actually comes through this cable right at the top of the gun. You see there's a big spool inside the machine itself, and it gets fed all the way out to here. With an arc welder, where you have to scratch and start and get it to start working, with a MIG welder, what you do is just get close to your metal and pull the trigger, and it starts all by itself. It feeds the wire in, so you don't have to keep worrying about where you are on the metal, and you can concentrate on getting a nice smooth weld going across there. Where the arc rod or the arc welder has this flux that melts off that you have to chip off, the MIG welder uses an inert gas. This is carbon dioxide and argon, and it comes out the hole around your wire, and that pushes the oxygen away from the weld and allows the metal to cool and seal itself where you don't have flux to chip off. A lot cleaner weld than arc. You have a little bit of splatter to clean up, but nowhere near as bad as an arc welder. The other kind of welder that I have is a TIG welder. And this is the gun for the TIG welder, the torch actually it's called. TIG stands for tungsten inert gas. This little electrode inside the torch, this is made out of tungsten. This is what actually carries the electricity to make the arc, to get the metal molten. So you can come back with your filler rod. Look familiar, right? It's almost exactly the same thing as the arc welder. But there's no flux on this. The TIG welder uses the same kind of compressed gas that the MIG welder does. This is straight argon instead of a mix, which allows you to do different types of metal like copper, nickel, bronze, brass, aluminum. You can do all kinds of weird metals with the TIG welder that you can't do with the MIG welder. The acronyms just get crazy after a while. But where, now see, this one is controlled with a foot pedal. Where the MIG welder, you just pull the trigger and things start happening. With a TIG welder, you have to push on the pedal just like in a car. The harder you push, the hotter the flame gets. You can control it much, much easier just by moving your foot up or down. You can get a hotter flame, colder flame. Once you get your arc started, you just sit there and feed your filler rod in as you're moving along and just melt it and fill it and whatever you have to do to get a nice smooth weld. On a lot of overlapping joints, if you're welding on the outside, you can do fuse welding where you don't even use filler rod. You just come in and melt the metal itself and just melt the two pieces together. Don't even have to add anything. A lot of times you don't even have to grind. So it's a nice, pretty clean weld. No spark, no splatter, no smoke. I love this. Hope that answers your question, Tim. Bye.